So good morning all of you student for another session on Fischer's concrete members. So here today we are going to see the analysis of symmetrical section again of Fischer's concrete beam. Okay, in that we are going to see today when tendon is placed with some eccentricity. Last lecture we have seen the tendon is placed with exactly at centroid axis. Today we are going to see what are the various stresses when tendon is placed at eccentricity. Okay, so eccentricity here we are going to consider the distance from tendon to the central axis of the beam, that is CG line of the beam. So here tendon is placed with an eccentricity E, and on that prestressing force is applied. Okay, so and this is simply supported typical beam. So we are going to see here how to calculate first the stresses. Okay, as early we have seen the problem where tendon is placed the centroidal axis along the central axis. In that case we have know that this beam is subjected with the stresses, which stresses? Direct stresses and bending stresses. The direct stresses due to this prestressing force and bending stresses due to the superimposed load and self weight of the beam. So here again same thing here. So here direct stresses we are going to calculate by considering P by A, prestressing force divided by area B into D. So we have got value of compression stress here, then compression stresses are positive. Okay, and next thing we are going to calculate the bending stresses. Bending stresses due to the superimposed load, that is M by Z. So M by Z already we have discussed, this is moment WL square by 8 along with the superimposed load plus the self weight of the beam. So that value is W, so WL square by 8 is the moment. Z is the section modulus, already we have discussed section modulus, BD square by 6. Okay, now new thing is here, comparative with this tendon is provided with the centroidal axis along the centroidal axis, and the tendon is provided with some eccentricity. The new thing is here this. New thing is this. What is new thing? The stresses due to the eccentricity. The stresses due to the eccentricity is going to develop. So how these stresses is going to develop? These are also bending stresses, because when we have provided the prestressing force here, this is centroidal axis. Okay, and due to this centroidal axis, this P into E, that moment is going to create like this. This P into E, okay, see this P into E here is the eccentricity. This P into E, the moment is going to act like this. Okay, moment is going to act like this, and due to this the beam is going to bend like this. The beam is going to bend like this, okay, due to this moment, like this. And here is at top tension beam is subjected, and compression here beam is subjected, okay, with provision of eccentricity E. Here is one change only, this eccentricity is not up to bottom, one change, one mistake here. So this eccentricity was only up to this, from central axis to the tendon. Okay, so this is E distance. So this here we have seen that eccentricity distance. So after getting this P into E, that moment is going to act like this. So tension at top and compression at bottom, vice versa. When we have seen the moment due to the self weight of the beam, okay, if this is beam, due to self weight of the beam, okay, beam is and superimposed load, beam is going to bend like this. So here compression here, tension at bottom, so it is exactly opposite. So that's why we have shown the diagram like this. The direction, tension direction this side and compression direction this time. The amount of bending stresses you are going to calculate here, a moment you are going to consider P into E. Okay, P into E is the moment. So this is extra additional stresses you are calculated due to eccentricity. M by tendon is placed with the eccentricity. Okay, so next here, after getting this value, we have to take addition of the all, and after getting the addition of all, we will get the formula like this. The combined stresses due to this direct stress, due to this bending stress, and due to this stresses due to the eccentricity. So you have got the value here. Now total final values, P by A minus P E by Z plus M by Z. So addition, this is positive, this is negative, this is positive. So this positive, okay, this positive P by A, this is negative, so negative, and this is positive. Same way we are going to calculate the stresses at bottom. So stresses at bottom here, P by A, this is positive, okay. So PE divided by Z, this is positive, and this is M by Z negative. So by considering this, we are going to calculate the stresses at top fiber and bottom fiber of beam, okay. Remember one thing, when there is a larger moment, a bending moment is maximum, in that case, to nullify that moment, if moment is maximum, suppose assume that if this value is 10 newton per mm square, okay, and the stress, compression stress here, suppose this value is 8, assume that only this value is 8, what happen, the net value will be 2 newton per mm square, and still the beam stresses in the beam in tension, okay. So to counteract that, we have to create the positive force. And how you are going to get this positive, this positive stress we are going to get additional moment, and additional moment how you are going to achieve, additional moment you are going to achieve by providing the tendon with the eccentricity. This is major advantage of that, providing the tendon with the eccentricity instead of providing the tendon at central axis, okay. How hope that you people have got the things now correctly. So by using this combined stresses formula, we are going to solve the problem, okay. So next we are going to see the problem. So hope that you people have understood that. So hope that you have understood why we have to provide the tendon with some eccentricity to get this advantage, okay. So now with the this thing, we are going to start with the problem now. So here, please pay attention. So this is problem we have taken. A prestressed concrete beam 400 by 600 mm in section has a span of 6 meter and is subjected to a uniform distributed load of 17 kN meter including the self weight of beam. The prestressing tendon, which are located at the lower third point and provide an effective prestressing force of 950 kN, determine the extreme fiber stresses in the concrete at the midspan section. So again here we have to calculate the stresses at midspan section. So here we are going to calculate the stresses at this midspan section, okay. So solution for this problem, again same thing, the formula already we have seen, which thing you required in formula. So formula, the things required formula is like this, the stresses at top fiber and bottom fiber. So P by A minus plus that pre-stress force eccentricity by Z, and then stresses due to the bending moment plus minus, and that is m by z, okay. So these terms now we have to calculate one by one. So first thing, we are going to calculate the area. So cross sectional area of beam 400 by 600, so that value is 2.4 × 10⁵, okay. Section modulus BD square by 6, that value is 400 into 600 square divided by 6, so this value is 2.4 × 10⁷. And maximum moment, this moment due to the bending moment due to self weight and superimposed load, that including the self weight of beam, so no need to calculate the extra weight of the beam. So WL square by 8, 17 × 10⁶, so that moment is 76.5. so direct stresses due to the pre-stressing force sigma d here, direct stresses P by A, that pre-stressing force given 950 × 10�³ divided by 2.4 × 10⁵, so this value become plus 3.96, okay. So got this thing. Next is the extreme stress due to the eccentricity. This is new thing, okay, which we have seen, that P into E divided by Z minus plus, so pre-stressing force into eccentricity. The tendon is going to act the third point, one third part, okay, of the lower part of the one third from the central axis. So one third distance is a 100 mm, because total cross section, if you can see here, the cross section of beam having total dimension 600 mm. If you are going to consider the central axis, this distance is 300, okay. And when we are providing the tendon is placed with that eccentricity of lower one third part, so one third of 300 will be the 100, so this 100, so why this why we have taken eccentricity 100 mm. So by providing eccentricity, we have got the stress here, the stress is 3.96 newton per mm square. So next is the extreme stress due to the bending moment. Bending moment already we have calculated, So m is 76.5 into 10 to 6, and z section models also we have calculated 2.4 into 10 to 7. So this value is plus minus 3.19. Okay. So now final stresses in the extreme fiber is as follow. So the same formula now we are going to use, which we have seen earlier. Okay. So this formula we have to use, and by using that we have to calculate the stresses of top fiber, that is sigma t here and sigma b. So what is sigma t and sigma b here? So sigma t, stresses at top fiber of the beam. So respective values you have to put in this formula. So this value get 3.19. Okay, and then addition of these two, okay, the final stresses in the extreme fiber, that value is 3.96 and 3.96. So this value plus 3.9 and plus 3.9. So direct stress here, final stress in the extreme bottom fiber will be here after putting the value 3.96, 3.96 and minus 3.19. Okay, so this value become now 4.73. Okay, so these are the stresses, final top stresses and bottom stresses. Now just we are going to show these stresses in a diagram. See here. So here you can see the cross section of beam 400 by 600 is intensity 100 mm. Cross section of beam, the stresses which you have calculated, PA 3.96. Direct stress, yes, direct stress due to the precipitation force, then stress due to the eccentricity is 3.96, and the bending stress here. Okay, so this value 3.16. So that calculated value here 3.19. Okay, and direct stress I think last 4.73. So here this value become 4.73. So this value here, so this value is not 3.3 plus 4.73 newton per square. Okay, so this is how we are going to calculate the stresses by considering the, by providing the tendon with the eccentricity here, by providing a tendon here, the stresses are top fiber and bottom fiber of the beam. Okay, so we are going to stop here, and next lecture we are going to see the again different problem, and we are going to continue with that. Okay, thank you very much for joining.